picture frame to encompass my light. So I think it's going to work out quite nicely. Oh, picture is on there. Oh, that's good. I know somebody who'd like that. So I'll put that away very, very carefully. And I'll protect it there. Okay. Oh, it's been made really good. Right. So what I need to do now is cut a piece of this plastic out. Excuse me. So what I'll do, made to measure, almost. Right. Don't know if you can see what I'm doing. I hope so. Light boards in a minute. There we go. Now which side goes up and which side goes down, I don't know. So I'll have to make the light board up, try it. Then turn it over, see, find out which way is best. As this is the more reflective surface, I think I'll put that up to start with and give that a go. Because the idea is that on the backboard, which I'm going to put on here, I'm going to have silver foil and then mount the LED light boards to it, so that it's got, goes down, reflects and then spreads. And the idea is to have a fluorescent light looking fitting without blobs of light here, there and everywhere. So again, I don't know how many light boards I'll be using, but as Kevin would say, he's, you're building a kitchen light, not a searchlight. And these will all be stood off with bolts from the backboard. Nylon bolts, by the way. So I don't have any problems worrying about shorts. It looks like I'm going to have to start making some more light boards. This project uses this many. Again, I don't know how many I shall need. I've been going on the luminosity of my boards. I think this is going to be overkill. So I think if I took out every other one, I think that might be enough, because that'd be the same effect as two bulbs. I mean, we could try that first. I'll drill the backboard for all of these. I'll put these in first, see how that goes, and then if needs be, then I'll already have the mounting holes to put these in.